night that covers me. Black is the pit from pole to pole. I thank Almighty God that be for my unconquerable soul. In the fell clutch of circumstance, I have not winced nor cried aloud. Under the bludgeonings of chance, my head is bloodied but unbowed. Beyond this place of wrath and tears, looms but the horrors of the shade. And yet the menace of the years finds and shall find me unafraid. It matters not how straight the gate, how charged with punishment the scroll. I am the master of my fate. I am the captain of my soul.
Hello again. I know you will be honest with me, and you always remind me what I really want to do. Life is short, and I don't want to regret. I've been unproductive and been inside too much. I had too much excuses. I need to go somewhere and do something meaningful. Thanks for telling me that.
I wanted to read from my old journals for this piece. Journal entries I hadn't read since I wrote them. Journals I seemingly only wrote as records for the ways people treated me. journals that I thought would be about myself, but hindsight is showing me that 14-year-old mind didn't care enough about the way I was feeling, just the way that other people felt around me. What is this obsession that I had with other people's feelings? Why did I feel like their actions against me were my own problems? I found journal entries of exes who had hurt me, and entries about my mom's excessive drinking. I found entries where all I'd do was blame myself for the violence against me and make excuses for the reasons I deserved it. I found entries confessing my love I had for these abusers in my life, but never once did I confess love for myself. Never once, not until now. This is a new journal entry. I'm making rules for myself, a rubric, if you will. There will be things I will not be allowed to include, phrases I will be banned from using. I wanted to create an empowering piece that showed my growth through side-by-side imagery of a past me and a current me. But for what? To continue to identify with the negative side of my past? No more. Now is now, and the only thing I'm identifying with is the growth I'm experiencing as I'm experiencing it, not the growth I'm having in comparison to my shitty past. So here it is, my new journal.
As a preteen, it frustrated me how my parents prohibited me from walking alone.
You simultaneously wish for someone to appear to protect you,
but you're incredibly fearful that if a person does appear, that they might harm you.
I'm always frightened. You walk
quickly and alertly, looking around every few seconds to check if no one is following you. And in rustling, footsteps or lone cars can create that adrenaline rush of fear.
I was commuting into work when I was approached by a man who was
was walking behind me. When I declined, he would not leave me alone and followed me on my route into work.
Even in a relatively busy city center,
it was dark.
He
was a lot bigger than me and walked pretty close to me despite social distancing.
It's the everyday thing.
I was really scared for my own safety.
The fear of being alone at night.
You push out the thoughts.
Catcalls on the street. That could happen.
Men twice my age staring.
And concentrate on
vulgar comments at the park with my friends.
Many women
these are
have
things
safely
that every
walked
woman
here before
has experienced,
and will do so,
and so
after you.
When it comes
maybe
to
my
being
fears
alone
are
in a public space at night
up in Yorkshire,
I found
during the
Peter
I'm naturally
Sutcliffe
more fearful.
Years, but those fears are real.
Just the
it's
thought of walking past
alert,
a group of men at
listen,
night is enough to have my heart beating.
So I can run
the sudden
if
realization of a new shadow
in, the end,
in front of me at night
only
has
I
me spinning around, prepared for the worst, only to find it's the shadow
it.
Of a lamp post
I was
above
paranoid
me.
For months about bumping into him again
country,
and changed
and
my commute routine.
Before it was gentrified
it's difficult for women. You're told to be polite and smile
and
be nice, even if you're feeling threatened. However, smiling and being
polite
can be an encouragement for harassment, but when you decline their advances,
the
situation is
more vulnerable to attacks.
However, it distracts me from my fear.
Claire,
Leslie,
42,
24,
marketing director,
Elaine,
24,
government
Sadia,
retired,
my Rotherham,
York.
Student, Taunton.
No puedes. Va a ser un gran verano. Por fin he terminado una estresante vida escolar, llena de tarea y muchos exámenes. ¿No puedes? Estoy muy emocionada para ir. Quiero verlos a todos. Ya me estoy preparando, alistando mi ropa. Escogí mis zapatos. ¿No puedes? Encontré fotos del verano pasado. Ya que lo pienso, tengo muchas divertidas memorias de ese verano. ¿No puedes? Preparo mi maleta. Preparo mi maleta. Ya, déjame preparar mi maleta. No puedes. Quiero ir. Quiero ir. Por favor. Quiero ir. No puedes.
Thank you. rise in attacks against Asian Americans across the country. Hate crimes against Asian Americans in major U.S. cities surged by nearly 150% in 2020, even as overall hate crimes fell. Stephanie Tsai has the story.
好，新闻疫情爆发之后呢，有些人不但要防疫，还要对抗种族歧视。一名住在美国旧金山的80岁亚裔老先生，日前在自家附近散步，突然遭到了陌生男子用力推倒在地，伤势过重，不幸死亡。事实上呢，自从疫情爆发以来，全美各地的针对亚裔族群的仇恨事件大幅的增加。不管是搭地铁，或是在餐厅吃饭，亚裔人士都常遭到种族歧视，甚至攻击。
Give paw. Other paw. Good boy. Give paw. Other paw. Give paw. Other paw. Give paw. Other paw. Other paw.
Truth is a thing which only appears to those who have observed, considered, and made a choice.
It's kinda quiet.
Cover yourself with paint. You're acting like you ain't afraid of what you've got in store for your fate. Are you ready? This is the day the world changes.
I love you.
The unprepared will be left behind.
Instead of looking for somewhere that I'll be needed, I'll decide what I want to do and go where I have to.
I thought my life would finally have meaning if I was special to someone.
Though, in the end, it's still like saying this isn't my true self.
I think I was scared. Scared to have someone else around.
You know, I think I'm okay with that.
There's no such thing as a real me or a fake me. But there will be a time when I can't change so easily.
In the end, the person I most wanted to accept me was myself. I feel as though life will eventually fall into place if I simply keep moving forward.
Yeah, yeah. Now dance.
Only I can save myself.
And I decided I'm not doing it just for myself.
So from now on, I got two rules. Rule one, be myself. Rule two, get people to understand me.
After all, it's my life.
Being a 22-year-old college student on the verge of graduation sucks. What's even suckier is that the sense of structure is going to go away, and I don't even know what goals I have for myself. As the days go on, I continue with my daily routine, trying my best not to think about the impending doom that lingers around the corner. What a life, right? I mean, it's hard not to think about it. It's inevitable at this point. But then again, let's look at my cats. When you really think about it, my cats live such a glorious lifestyle. Sleeping all day, not worrying about real life responsibilities, eating, having a roof over their heads. I mean, look at them. All they ever do is sleep, walk around, bug me for food, eat, sleep some more, lounge around. No worries about their future, job security, societal standards, financial worries. You get the point. Today, we're gonna be a cat. Let's go. When the sun is up, the sun gets pretty cool, but the sight of the waiters don't get much. They're looking forward to the lunch. And when we fill it up, a lorry comes and drags it. The luxurious lifestyle. Channeling the feline energy feels so liberating. I'm free to wander around aimlessly, relax, observe things from a different perspective. All I just have to worry about is looking cute enough to manipulate my humans to do whatever I want. While being a cat is fun and all, I have to realize that it's not me. Well, obviously, duh, I'm not an actual cat, but what I'm trying to say is that I'm Sophia. I am a human. I exist on this planet just as everyone else does. I have my worries, troubles, ups and downs, etc. Even though I may not know exactly what my purpose is for being here, what I do know is I'm happy to be me. I'm thankful that I get to wake up every day and experience what life has to offer. We all really just have to make the best out of everything. And just continue to do what we want and what makes us happy.
Dear society, I like walking. I think walking alone is therapeutic. But here are 5 things I'm conscious of while I walk. Number 1. I have 4 things in my pockets. My phone, my keys, my pepper spray, and my taser. Number 2. It's daytime. Number 3. I told someone where I was, and they have my location. Number 4. I walk towards the traffic, not with it. And number 5. If I were in trouble, I know people are more likely to help if I yell fire instead of help. Dear society, now that you know, how does it feel to know that you're failing me, failing girls? Because what if I forgot my protection at home? What if I had to walk to my car at night? What if my phone was separated from me? What if my destination meant I had to walk with traffic? And what if I yelled, but it was too late? What then? Because it really isn't about how well I protect myself. It's all because I'm a girl, and you hate me. You want me to take responsibility for my own safety, so that you can blame me when things go wrong. I like walking, but I don't like being a walking target.
Oh, Where am I going? Where am I walking? Why am I even outside? It feels nice out. I'm unfocused, but I can't zone back in. I don't know what I'm doing, but I feel so comfortable. Am I dreaming? I'm stuck in repetition. Why am I doing the same thing again? It feels nice though. The warm sun kissing my skin. I still don't know where I'm going. I remain unfocused, but the world looks so beautiful when you're not part of it. This world has many beautiful things to offer, but it's interesting just how easily you can get distracted by the simplest things.
Would you love me the same if I take off this makeup? Would you love me the same if I wasn't made up? Would you look me in the face? Yeah, yeah. All of these scars and this pain I've covered with makeup. On and off relationships, I'm sick and tired of doing this. And I know that you're not to blame. You've been trying hard to love, but I can't let my guard down that easy. You know that my heart is too weak. If that's not what you want, then you better tell me before I start catching feelings. Would you love me the same if I take off this makeup?
Take off this makeup.
Would you love me the same if I wasn't made up?
I wasn't made up.
Would you look me in the face? Yeah, yeah. All of these scars and this pain I've covered with makeup. And I can judge you. I can judge. You can leave if I'm too much. How do you want me to be so faithful? You've been trying hard to love, but I can't let my guard down that easy. You know that my heart is too weak. If that's not what you want, then you better tell me before I start catching feelings. Would you love me the same if I take off this makeup? Would you love me the same if I wasn't made up?
I wasn't made up.
Would you look me in the face? Yeah, yeah. All of these scars and this pain.
Thank you.